You are watching The Story. Every Monday, we bring you a deep dive into the fascinating lives of incredible people. How Anthony Bourdain changed food culture. Welcome to Alux.com, the place where future billionaires come to get inspired. In rare instances, one person will come along and make such an impact on an industry that it can never be the same again. And today, we're talking about one of these influential people. There are few industries in this world that are vital to each of the 7.5 billion people that live on this planet. And this is what sets the food industry apart. When Anthony Bourdain came onto the scene, he immediately began to change people's perceptions about food, and throughout the course of his career, he was able to single-handedly change the food culture in the United States and beyond. Today, we're going to talk about how he did this, but first, who is Anthony Bourdain? Although Anthony helped establish the so-called rockstar chef movement, he's in a category all his own. He was a talented chef, a passionate traveler, an introspective thinker, and an engaging storyteller, an innovator and an award-winning television personality and author. He's most well known for his television shows, No Reservations and Parts Unknown. He also wrote 9 books and a number of articles and essays. He was very opinionated and didn't worry about what people thought of him. He didn't get what he called his lucky break until he was in his 40s and never took his success for granted. Sadly though, the world lost Anthony in 2018 to suicide, but the legacy he left behind is a powerful one. Although he often brushed off claims he had revolutionized food culture, his impact is undeniable. But let's take a step back and look at where it all began. Beginnings. After graduating from the Culinary Institute of America in 1978, Bourdain began a long career in the restaurant industry, ultimately becoming an executive chef in Manhattan. In 1999, he published an essay in The New Yorker entitled "Don't Eat Before Reading This," in which he uncovered some trade secrets of how restaurants operate behind the scenes. His unique voice and his distinctive perspective were immediately apparent, and this simple article was the start of a journey Anthony never could have imagined. He became more well-known in 2000 when he published his book Kitchen Confidential: Adventures in the Culinary Underbelly. Many of the depictions he had seen of the restaurant world simply didn't ring true, so he set out to write a book that his fellow restaurant workers could relate to. This book rocked the restaurant industry and immediately began to change the way people thought about eating out. But this was just the beginning. The vision. The success of his book made him a celebrity and gave him a new platform with a captive audience. From the beginning, his vision was to strip away all of the extras and represent the restaurant business and food culture in a completely frank and honest way. He wanted to present the truth, no matter how ugly or unsettling it may be. As he worked on No Reservations, his vision gradually evolved into changing the way people talked about and thought about food. Thanks to his unique platform and his willingness to engage in authentic food experiences around the world, Anthony completely changed food culture in a variety of ways. The ways he changed how we look at food. First, let's talk about how he changed how we look at food. Anthony always saw food as way more than just sustenance. It's an experience, it's an adventure, it's a way to bring people together. He wanted people to think beyond the food itself, to the experience that surrounds it. Anthony found that the question of who is cooking the food is much more interesting through his television shows. Bourdain showed us how food ties us together as a global family. It's a common need that everyone shares that is fulfilled in an infinite number of ways. The stories Anthony told helped connect people across cultures, generations, and beliefs through the shared experience of food. He not only changed how people look at food, but also where people choose to eat. He changed where we eat. Bourdain often emphasized that just because food is cheap doesn't mean it's not good. When Bourdain wrote his first bestseller, fine dining was considered the pinnacle of the eating experience, and five-star restaurants have always been put on a pedestal. And while they certainly have their place in food culture, Anthony showed us that food from a street vendor or a hole in the wall can offer just as satisfying a culinary experience. In his travels, he highlighted cheap foods that he bought on the street, like jerk chicken in Jamaica, tamales in Chicago, and fresh blue tortillas in Mexico City. He showed the world that there are many more rich food experiences to be had if we just set aside our preconceived notions and food snobbery to explore different dining options. He taught us that when it comes to food, it's often better to take the road less traveled. Bourdain also pioneered a new movement of food tourism. Through his 9 seasons of No Reservations and 12 seasons of Parts Unknown, Anthony explored every corner of the world, including France, Iran, Iceland, Jamaica, Malaysia, Korea, Ghana, and so many more. He approached different cultures through the lens of food and told people's stories in a frank and unapologetic way. Food tourism has been a thing for a long time, but Anthony broadened the scope of the industry far beyond the typical destinations like France and Italy. Now, people are booking flights to places like Hanoi, Vietnam, one of Anthony's favorite places in the world, to try bún chả, a traditional dish Anthony shared with President Obama on one of his most notable episodes. The World Food Travel Association has found that 93% of people consider food as a major factor in deciding where to travel to, and largely thanks to Bourdain, more unique food experiences are also in high demand. But as you can imagine, changing where we eat also goes hand in hand with changing what we eat. He changed what we eat. Anthony had a policy that he would never say no to any food he was offered, and he liked to say that good food and good eating are about risk. This led him to eating some very unusual dishes, including a cobra heart, maggot fried rice, a raw seal eyeball, live octopus, and many varieties of mystery meat. He didn't enjoy everything, though. For example, he recalled eating the Icelandic delicacy of hákarl, also known as fermented shark, as one of the worst food-related experiences of his life. But he did enjoy more food than he hated, so he encouraged people to get out of their comfort zones and not be so afraid to try something new. He also told people not to get hung up on appearances of food, because it's only the flavor that truly matters. Bourdain's explorations of exotic food cultures played a large part in the rise of more diverse restaurants in the US, particularly those that offer Asian cuisine from countries like Vietnam, Singapore, and the Philippines. He also helped bring popularity to foods that were previously seen as undesirable, such as organ meats, to mainstream menus. This is just one more way that Anthony Bourdain changed food culture in America and beyond. The lesson. There are so many lessons to be learned from Anthony's insights and experiences. He showed us that if we are brave enough to break out of the safety and security of the familiar, there are untold discoveries to be made that will forever change the way we think and the way we experience life. Not every risk results in a reward, but there is value in taking bold action, no matter what the consequence. If we're not shackled by others' expectations and opinions, we will experience a new kind of freedom that could take us to some truly incredible places. For further insights into Bourdain's journey from an unknown chef to revolutionary figure in the food world, check out his 2010 book, Medium Raw, A Bloody Valentine to the World of Food and the People Who Cook. In this deeply honest and transparent memoir of sorts, Bourdain reflects on his experiences and the condition of the food industry as a whole. And while the information in this book is worth every penny, you can save yourself about $30 if you go to alux.com/freebook and sign up, where you can get the audiobook version for free, thanks to our partnership with Audible. The quote. While researching his story, we've come across this incredible quote from Anthony we'd love to share with you. It goes like this. Without experimentation, a willingness to ask questions and try new things, we shall surely become static, repetitive, and moribund. So, no matter where you are in life, don't get complacent. Venture out into the unknown and continue to make discoveries. Question. Now that we've talked about the incredible impact Bourdain has made on food culture, we'd like to know, what's the craziest or most unique dish you have ever eaten? Let us know in the comments. And of course, for watching with us until the end, you know you get a bonus. Here it is. Before Anthony found success as a chef, he dropped out of Vassar College after 2 years of studying and struggled for a long time with his addictions to cocaine and heroin. Thank you for spending some time with us, Aluxers. Make sure to like and subscribe so you never miss another video. We also handpicked these videos, which we recommend you watch next. You can talk to us on all social medias or ask a question on our website, alux.com. Thank you for being an Aluxer, and we'll see you back tomorrow.